All right, time for show and tell now on your Friday, and I send it right back to Cody Stark. It's our time.
Okay, all right. I woke up this morning. I'm so bummed about this, but I can't even begin to tell you how I feel about Marty Sklar. Marty Sklar passed away
last
night.
Yes, I saw that.
He was an Imagineer for Disney, and not just an Imagineer for Disney. I mean, he might be responsible for everything that we think about Disney. When Walt passed away, Marty was the guy that kept the idea of what Disney was supposed to be going on. He was on our show a couple times, so I got to interview Marty, and you would have thought that I met Elvis. Marty was so gracious and so nice, and I won't play for some reason. He was so gracious, so nice, and I just kept peppering him with questions. One of the things about Marty was when Walt passed away, think about this. He passed away, he got a page, and they said, hey, Walt just died, and it was sudden, nobody knew. Mm-hmm. And they said, you've got an hour. We want you to encapsulate his life and then go tell the world that Walt Disney has passed away. He had 1 hour to write this press release.
Oh, my gosh.
About Walt Disney.
About Walt Disney.
He was a legend and probably his close personal friend.
Yeah. And then,
oh, my gosh.
Walt passed away right before the Pirates of the Caribbean ride opened up. So that gives you an idea of where the park was and the whole idea of the Disney park system and everything. This is before Epcot. This is before Disney Paris. But Marty was there for all those projects, and he was in charge of all those projects. I almost want to cry thinking about it. But what a neat, neat guy.
Yeah.
The Epcot Center story that he told me was amazing. Walt had this idea for something to do at the park, and it's this experimental park of tomorrow, you know, that's what Epcot's supposed to be. Walt passed away and didn't really tell anybody what it was.
Oh.
And so they all turned to Marty and said, okay, go. And so Epcot Center really came from Marty. He had to figure out what Walt was talking about and then built it all up from there. And Marty, one of the most impressive things, I think, is he was responsible for making sure that your experience at Disneyland in Southern California and Disney Paris and Disney Tokyo would be the same. So you can go on a Thursday to Disneyland and go to Paris, and it feels the same,
feels
even though it's
same.
A different park and everything.
Yeah.
But they could duplicate that experience, and it's all because of Marty.
He should have called it Sklar World.
You really could. And
he signed this
for me, and it's one of my treasured things. He says, Cody, all good things in the future, Marty Sklar. Really neat guy.
That's neat. Wow. Yeah, I saw that this morning, and he's one of those names that probably unless you met him like you did, you would not have known that he was such a big force behind the whole Disney enterprise.
Just super humble, super nice, greatest.
He looks like a guy who could just be walking down the street like he worked at a bank.
Yeah. Neat guy.
You know?
So he passed away 83 years old, but what a life this guy had.
No kidding.
What
footprints. Real footprints.
Footprints for sure. Mm-hmm. Well, thanks for sharing that. And that's neat that you have that book. I'm glad you have that. That's cool.